A major GNOME desktop upgrade is finally here, GNOME 40. This release is particularly interesting because of its major visual changes, or rather, unusual for some users. This is Ankush from It's First, and here I am going to mention a few key highlights about GNOME 40. You will find several subtle visual improvements, which is always a good thing for users looking for attention to details. But the most surprising change is the revamped activities overview along with a horizontal dock app menu. Personally, it looks good to me with all the new colorful icons. Even the app drawer and the ability to reposition the icons in the app grid is indeed a useful addition. However, the horizontal app menu and the change to horizontal workspaces will break the workflow for many. Of course, a lot of other desktops behave the same way, but if you are comfortable with the vertical workflows, you will need to adjust and get acquainted with the new change. Basically, with multi-monitor setup, the transition and the navigation of workspaces should be more meaningful and consistent. However, with multiple horizontal displays, the layout of the workspaces might clash, and you will have to eventually adjust with the design change. So that's a bummer. GNOME 40 will display the workspaces in the primary display by default, but it also supports navigation of workspaces in the secondary display if you have a multi-monitor setup. So that's a good thing. The development team believes that having horizontal workspaces will not only make it simpler, but also allows for the ability to have improved navigation, especially using touchpad. You'll know it when you try it. With GNOME 40, you also get to add creation date column in the file manager app that was missing for a long time. Other minor highlights include some improvements to the GNOME web browser, ability to add Last.fm account in the list of online accounts from the settings, and a couple of enhancements to the GNOME software app. You will also find several improvements to the default GNOME apps, like the calculator app with useful shortcuts, and improved load time for GNOME apps, and so on. GNOME 40 is available right now, but don't expect it with Ubuntu 21.04. You can either wait for Fedora 34 release to try it, or install the GNOME OS as a virtual machine instance using the GNOME Boxes application. Personally, I'm not very excited about the visual changes, but it will be definitely interesting to see how Ubuntu and PopOS implements it in their future releases. You might want to read our article on GNOME 40 linked in the description to explore more about it. What do you think about GNOME 40? Feel free to let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Thanks to Linode for partnering with us for this video.